the end of one journey, but the start of another struggle. Hundreds of thousands of Rohingya refugees have been making their way to Bangladesh since the Myanmar military launched a brutal crackdown in August. The Rohingya say they had no choice but to leave.
We left our homeland because the people in Rakhine were killing us. They shot at us, they took our cattle and burnt our houses, so we have come here.
They're safe here, but life in Bangladesh is difficult. The camps are overflowing. People here are entirely dependent on aid. The country and humanitarian agencies are feeling the strain. Bangladesh and Myanmar have now taken the first step towards repatriating recent arrivals. They've signed a memorandum of understanding. But there's very little detail about how the process of returning Rohingya to Myanmar will take place. Myanmar leader Aung San Suu Kyi, in an address to the nation last month, said Myanmar was ready to start a verification process following the same principles as a 1993 agreement with Bangladesh. Under that deal, Rohingya could return if they could prove their residency and had national identity cards or other relevant documents issued by the authorities. But the Myanmar military, still a very powerful institution here, said in a statement that the verification process would also have to be in accordance with the 1982 citizenship law, a law that's been used to deny citizenship to the Rohingya. But after what they've lived through, and many refugees have been given consistent accounts of murder, arson and rape at the hands of Myanmar military and Buddhist mobs, many Rohingya will choose not to return to a country that seems intent on keeping them out. Florence Looi, Al Jazeera, Yangon.